city when we were kids. It is great to be back. Thank you. We have won 7 out of the last 8 caucuses and primaries. And when I look at an unbelievable crowd like this, I believe we're going to win here in New York next Tuesday. If you want a candidate who is prepared to stand up to big money interests, to take on the greed of corporate America, the fraud of Wall Street, if you want that candidate, we need your help. And amazingly, in the last 11 months, we have received almost 7 million individual campaign contributions. That is more campaign contributions than any candidate in the history of this country at this point in the campaign. Does anybody know what our average campaign contribution is? $27 average campaign contribution. And why this is revolutionary is that it shows we can run a winning campaign without being dependent on the big money interests. If you think that you are going to continue to throw American workers out on the street and move abroad, you got another guess coming, because it ain't gonna happen if I'm president. Everybody, the only way we take on Wall Street, take on corporate America, take on the corporate media, take on the wealthy campaign contributors. The only way we do that is when millions of people stand up and demand a government that represents all of us. All of us, and not just the 1%. How could it be that in this great country today, the top 0.1% now own almost as much wealth as the bottom 90%? How could it happen that the 20 wealthiest people in America now own more wealth than the bottom 150 million Americans? In Seattle, Washington, $15 an hour. Los Angeles, San Francisco, $15 an hour. Oregon, California, New York, $15 an hour. What all of that is about is telling us that when people look around them at the status quo and they say that the status quo no longer works, and when they stand up by the millions, despite what others may tell you, yes, we can change the status quo. When I look at an unbelievable crowd like this, I believe we're going to win here in New York next Tuesday. should we have more people in jail than any other country? Why aren't we doing more to combat a crumbling infrastructure, roads, bridges, water systems? Why are we not more aggressive in transforming our energy system? Why are we allowing billionaires to buy elections through a corrupt campaign finance system? These are the questions. These are the questions that millions of Americans are now asking themselves. And what they are concluding is that establishment politics and establishment economics are not going to address those crises. What they are concluding is we cannot take seriously candidates who receive millions of dollars from the most powerful and greedy special interests in America, who then go forward and say, we're going to stand up to those special interests. Nobody believes that. Real change never occurs from the top on down. It is always from the bottom on up. And when we do not allow the Donald Trumps of the world to divide us up, there is nothing we cannot accomplish. In this country, people will have the right to love each other no matter what their gender is. Together, we will not allow that American dream to die. Together, we are going to create an economy that works for all of us, for the elderly, the children, the sick, the poor, the middle class, and the working families of this country, not just the 1%. Well, corporate America, bad news. Change is coming. Gonna have to start paying your fair share of taxes. We're gonna use that $100 million a year to invest in our infrastructure and create billions of decent paying jobs. Does not do its job, I will use the executive powers that the president has. You know what I think? When I look out at the thousands of people who are here tonight, the thousands of people we saw in Buffalo and Syracuse and Rochester, we've got a surprise for the establishment. I think that if we have a large voter turnout on Tuesday, we're going to win this thing. Thank you.